Kapi'olani Park is well known for picnics and family-friendly festivals. Now there's a chance that alcohol will be served at special events. The city is holding a public hearing next month on a proposal to serve alcoholic beverages at Queens Beach. Alcohol is prohibited at all public parks. We wanted to know why the city is doing this, so Manolo Morales got some answers. Manolo?
The proposal is for the area across the street from Kapi'olani Park, and the city tells me it's not taking a position on this, but the Department of Parks and Recreation is putting this out there at the request of event organizers. Signs are posted all around Kapi'olani Park naming all the things not allowed, and among them is alcohol. But the city wants some feedback from the public that would allow event organizers to serve alcohol at Queens Beach in the area by the volleyball courts. The city points out that drinks will be served, not sold, and it will only be done at special permitted events. The event is by invitation only and not open to the public, and the service area will be clearly marked by barriers and fencing.
That seems inappropriate. It's a family park. It's one of the few open spaces we have for families to go to where it's free.
Alethea Redman is the board president of the Kapi'olani Park Preservation Society, a nonprofit group that also opposed allowing alcohol at the Honolulu Zoo. The Honolulu Liquor Commission rejected it after hearing from the public. Redman tells me serving alcohol at the park is bad enough, and the idea of having a private event at a public park makes it even worse.
Kapi'olani Park is supposed to be free and open to the public with certain commercial events allowed, but it has to be public access. You or I can buy a ticket to it. So if it's a private VIP event, that's a real problem.
We asked park users about it and we got mixed responses, but even those who are in favor of it have some concerns.
I think like anything, the problem is that it only takes one person to ruin it for everybody. So hopefully if that doesn't happen, which is I feel is kind of inevitable, it'd be okay. I'd be okay with it at least.
While others just tell me that it sets a bad precedent.
This is a public park and there's a lot of sports activities for the kids. So I would say no. That would be a big no for me.
After a public hearing, the proposal will then be considered by the City Department of Parks and Recreation. And if it approves it, the measure will then be considered by the Liquor Commission. Now, that public hearing is scheduled for January 8th from 2 to 4 p.m. at Mission Memorial Auditorium. We will keep track and let you know if the proposal moves forward. Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.